Let's start by laying down on our back. Bend your knees, feet flat on the floor. Feet could be slightly apart. Arms by your side, slightly away from your waist. Palms facing up. And gently close your eyes. And start to pay attention to your breathing. Take an inhale and feel your ribs expanding, and exhale, feel the ribs drawing in. Take another inhale and feel that your abdomen fill up with the air and your abdomen falling as you exhale. Take another inhale, ribs expand, abdomen rise, chest rise, and exhale, ribs drawing in, abdomen and chest falling. Continue to breathe in and out through your nostril. And from here, I invite you to bring your awareness to the soles of your feet. And let's bring the attention to the base of your big toes. And start to sense that contact that you made with the earth through those two points under your big toes. And maybe start to apply a gentle pressure, pressing against the mat. And let's bring our awareness to the base of your little toes. And maybe start to engage those points. Feel that they are making contact with the earth. And press gently against the ground. So maintain those contact points, the base of the big toes and base of the little toes, as you shift your awareness all the way back to your heels and find that center of your heels. And apply a gentle pressure, pressing against the mat. And now that you have brought awareness to all those three points and making physical contacts with the earth, could you feel the connection of your feet with the earth through those points? It's all right if this is something new and it doesn't make any sense for now, but for today I will only invite you to bring some awareness to these three points on both of your feet, and hopefully we can use that awareness and the knowledge in our practice today. And while we are still here, I would like to invite you to think of a sankalpa, which is intention or a mindset for today's practice or for your day in general. share my sankapa for today's practice, which is I'm staying connected to the earth. I'm staying connected to the earth. Take an inhale and exhale and start to open your eyes. So stay in this half corpse pose or Ardha Shavasana, and with the next inhale start to arch your lower back and tilt your tailbone towards the mat, and exhale, flatten the lower back and scoop your tailbone in, and maybe your sacrum will be lifted slightly off the mat. Inhale, arch your lower back, tailbone pointing down. Exhale, scoop the tailbone in and continue. This is similar to the cat and cow stretches that we usually do in all four position, but the focus will be more on the lower back if we are doing it in a laying down position. And relax your spine. So maybe your spine will come along with the movement of your hips. So as you inhale and arching your back, your chin will be tucked in slightly closer to your chest. And with the exhale, tailbone tuck in and chin up slightly. Continue, few more breaths. Move slowly, feeling the articulation of your hips and spine. One more inhale, exhale, and back into a neutral spine, sacrum on the mat. Straighten your legs, feet slightly apart, bend at the elbow, interlace the finger and place the interlaced hands under your head, rest your head on your hand. So keep that head and your back in contact with the mat. As you exhale and side bend to the right, thinking of bringing that right elbow to the right hip. Of course they will never touch each other, but just thinking of going to that direction. And when you cannot go further, stay there in your side bend and imagine a beach ball in between your thighs and knees, and attempt to squeeze that imaginary beach ball. You are not actually bringing the legs together, but it's more of a muscle activation of squeezing your thighs together, activating your inner thighs. Continue to breathe. Exhale and release. Make your way back to the center. Take an inhale and exhale, side bending to the left. Bring your left elbow towards your left hip. And when you cannot go further, stay and squeeze that imaginary beach ball between your thighs and knees again. Feel your legs engage, especially your inner thighs. Breathe. And with the next exhale, move your way back to the center. Spread your arms wide to the side, palms facing up, and this time we will lift the right hip up, so your right buttocks will be off the mat, and twist that hip, the right hip, towards the left and swing your left arm to the right side. So this is a twist. Your hip is twisting to the left, while your torso is twisting to the right side. Stay and breathe in your twist. Exhale, release. Put the right buttock down on the mat. Spread your arms. Take an inhale and exhale. Lift that right and left buttocks off the mat. Twisting the left hip to the right side. And then swing your right arm to the left. One more inhale, exhale, and bring everything back to center, arm spread wide to the side. Bend your right knee, interlace your fingers and grab the front of your right knee, and start to bounce the knees up and down, and relax your left leg. And bring it along in the movement. Relax your spine, your neck, your head, and bring them along to in this gentle rocking motion. Release the right knee. Extend the right leg and switch. Bend the left knee. Grab the knee. Start to bounce the knees first. And as you relax the right leg, it will also join in the rocking movement. And finally, relax your torso, the spine, the neck and the head, and bring all of your body together in this rocking motion. And release, bend the other knees, bring them together as you move yourself to the side and gently push yourself up to seated. And then let's all move to all four position. You will be on your hands and your knees. And start to circle your shoulders above your wrist. Start with a small circle, simple movement. And you, if you feel like to, you can make the circle bigger. Moving in all direction, back, front, right and left, in a smooth circular part. And reverse the circle. Continue to breathe. We don't have to match the breathing with the movement, but just make sure that you continue to breathe as you continue to move. And start to make the circle smaller and smaller. And finally come to a stillness in this all four. Spread the fingers, press the hands firmly against the ground. Tuck the back toes and lift the knees off the mat. and stay there for a few breaths. And start to rock back and forth. And if you would like to, you can stay in this rocking movement, or even drop your knees and take a rest in child's pose. Or otherwise, you could try the next one, which is rock forward, straighten the legs, and come into your plank. Stay in plank for a few breaths and build some strength in the pose. Press firmly against the ground. Lift your spine up. Squeeze the glutes. Squeeze your thighs. Engage the legs. One more breath. Exhale and lift your hip up and towards the back into an inverted V position or downward facing dog. Bend the knees for now. Tip your tailbone up. And if you would like to try to straighten the knees and bring your heels to touch the mat behind you. If that's not happening today, that's fine. Just keep a slight bend in your knees. And start to pedal the legs. Bend one knee, straighten the other knee, and switch. And then continue to pedal as you move the feet closer and closer towards your hands. And finally, your feet are in between your hands and you are in your forward fold. So here, let's recall back those 3 points on both of our feet. The base of big toe, base of little toe, and center of the heel. Reconnect to those points and ground them towards the ground. And hopefully, if you do that, you could feel that your legs muscles straight away engaging. I could even feel it in my back. Relax your shoulders and neck. Bend the knees slightly if you need to. Stay in your forward fold for one more breath. And with the next inhale, start to lift your head, your torso up into halfway lift, and continue to make your way up. Spread the arms to the side. Take one big inhale and reach your arms to the ceiling. Exhaling, bring the arms down, hands by your side.